DC motor plays an important role in many electrical and electronics applications. In this video, we are going to learn about how DC motor works and what are the parts it contains. The DC motor runs in direct current, so it is called the DC motor. It works based on a magnet. Let's see about magnetism. The magnet is classified into two. They are permanent magnet and electromagnet. The permanent magnet is a type of magnet whose magnetic field remains constant. Whenever any metal near to the permanent magnet will attract immediately, on the other hand, the electromagnet acts as a magnet while applying electricity on it. After the electricity is cut off, it remains as metal. For example, take a metal and consider this as a magnetic domain. Now, wrap with copper coil and connect both ends with battery terminals. Here, electromagnetic field will be created. If you place a permanent magnet near to it, either attract or ripple. While you disconnect the battery, it remains as usual metal. The basic property of magnetic is, the same poles repel and opposite poles attract. If you place south and south or north and north will repel as well as north and south will attract. The DC motor works this way. Let's see some basic examples. Now, take two different permanent magnets as south and north. Place copper coil between two magnets as a rotor. At the end of the copper coil, there is a fixed ring called a commutator. The commutator is split equally. At both ends of the commutator, brushes are connected. The brush connects the commutator and electricity terminal by spring tension and helps to pass electricity to the commutator ends. Now, connect battery terminals. This coil is acting as a magnet. This is a perfect example of electromagnetism. In this coil, south and north poles are generated. On the other hand, the permanent magnets are already in process. Now, north pole is creating a north permanent magnet side as well as south pole is creating a south permanent magnet side. According to the magnet property, the same poles ripple. As a result, south and north permanent magnets are trying to push this coil away. But, the coil is fixed as a rotating element. Now, ripple effects of both magnetic forces will lead to rotation of this coil. This way the DC motor works. Now, carefully watch the rotation of this coil. After every half revolution, the magnetic poles are flipping. If we run such a DC motor, the coil will be stuck between magnets. Because opposite poles attract each other. Here, the commutator comes. The commutator is split equally. You can notice, the gaps between commutators will continue to change positive and negative terminals with brushes. As a result, whenever the coil completes its half revolution, also magnetic poles change. The other problem in this type of DC motor, whenever the coil comes perpendicular to the magnetic field, both magnetic forces will be the same. The two opposite equal forces will be zero. Therefore, the coil will not rotate at stable speed. Place another coil perpendicular to this coil. Whenever one coil gets zero force, another will be at maximum. Now, this DC motor can run effectively. In DC motor arrangement, there will be four pairs of coils. Let's take a closer look at the DC motor. Inside the DC motor, a copper coil is wrapped. If you place a copper coil between magnets and connect electrical terminals, the coil will rotate. The problem is in this arrangement, the copper coil is flexible, so we can't run such a DC motor. To overcome this issue, armature is used. The armature looks like a single solid unit. Actually, this is not a single unit. Number of steel sheets are laminated as a single unit. On this armature, copper coils are wrapped. This arrangement of copper coil is called armature winding. The number of coil arrangements are increased to rotate the DC motor effectively. Both terminals of armature windings are connected with commutators. The insulator is placed between shaft and commutators to isolate commutators. By this isolation of the commutator, two different poles of magnet can be achieved. To obtain more torque, the number of coils arrangement and electricity ampere should be increased. From this video, we understood what is DC motor, working principle of DC motor, and difference between permanent magnet and electromagnet. I hope that you have learned something new today. To watch these types of videos, make sure to subscribe to this channel. Thank you!